Hey, I'm Chris J from the band Army of Freshmen out of Ventura, California, and you're watching Craufurd TV. So I can really get carried away because I've been here for 2 weeks now, so it could get out of control. But for me, the worst thing about touring over here in the United Kingdom is the weather and the jet lag. And obviously that changes. If you come over here in the fall and come over in the spring or even the summer, it's much, much nicer. And it's a great experience. But we're here in late November, and man, I mean, it is so dark and so gray all the time. I like that every once in a while to change things up, but it's just brutal. And you mix that with jet lag, which is natural because we're from California. We're not an East Coast band. So we don't have the ability of, we're only a couple hours off. We have to fly across a whole country, a big one, and then a whole ocean to get here. So our schedules are super messed up. So every time I come over here, I end up getting cold or getting sick. I just can't help it. It always, always, always happens. So that to me is the most frustrating thing. It's just the weather and the jet lag. But you can deal with jet lag when the sun's out. But when it's dark all day, your body's naturally feeling like it needs to go back to bed. You just can't trick it into the new schedule, you know? So yeah, the weather in November in the UK is rough and the jet lag is rough, but you're having so much fun, you fight through it. If you were doing something shitty and you had bad weather and jet lag, I'm sure you'd be in a bad mood. But when you're having fun playing shows, you gotta stay positive.
Last night in London, it was tremendous. It was a newer venue called the Brooklyn Bowl, and it kind of felt like we were in Vegas or something. It didn't feel like proper, you know, English club, dark as fuck, really cold, sticky floors. It was really nice, really kind of posh. There was bowling going on, and London shows are always a little bigger. It's just such a big city. So it was nice to play in front of the biggest crowd of the tour, but they were rocking out, which was cool, because sometimes just because you have a big crowd, you know, it doesn't mean it's necessarily great. And tonight here at Craufurd Arms was awesome, just because, you know, you just get that release. You feel like you can let it all out on stage. You don't have to save yourself for another show, or you don't have to worry if you get, like I fell at night and hit my knee. I'd be freaking out if I had another show tomorrow, but I'm just gonna be sitting on a plane all day. So there's some benefits to that last show, and the crowd was rocking and big for a Sunday night, and the energy was there. So I'd say London and tonight really stood out. We also did a solo show in Leeds that wasn't part of the Lit Tour, which we're on now, and that was cool because it was a small place, but it was all our fans. Everybody that was there to see us. There wasn't the old guy in the back just drinking a beer that wasn't going to bop his head no matter what. You know, it was 100 people just singing along, having fun. So Leeds, Milton Keynes, London, I think were my three favorites.
Good question. We listen to all sorts of different stuff. So I think Army of Freshmen, we've been around for a long time, but everybody in the band is music fans. Everybody in our band listens to a lot of music and a lot of different music. So I think our personal influences are all over the board. But if you were talking directly about Army of Freshmen, we do sort of a pop, we a little bit of pop, little bit of punk, little bit of sort of new wave with the keyboards, even a little bit of rap, kind of spoken word with some of the stuff I do. I would say one of the biggest influences on us was a band called The Hippos. When we first started, we were very, very big fans of them. They put out a record called Heads Are Gonna Roll. They had a lot of keyboards, and that to us made us say, oh, maybe we should do, we got two guys in the band that play keyboards, maybe we should, you know, really sort of push that element of a little bit and really poppy stuff. I think, so The Hippos are a big influence. Real Big Fish was always a big influence in terms of their stage show and the energy and how tight they were. The first Weezer record, I think, is just a blueprint for any band that writes pop songs. Weezer Blue has always been one of our favorite albums. I think we always try to achieve to write songs that have the hooks that are on that record. So I'd say early Weezer, The Hippos, Real Big Fish. Lyrically speaking, from what I do, I mean, They Might Be Giants is always a band I've really loved. Very smart, quirky, interesting lyrics. I think if you put a mix of They Might Be Giants, The Hippos, Real Big Fish, and Weezer, I think ultimately out comes Army of Freshmen. Yeah. When I was only a kid, I hid in the pyramids, like the Island of Kings, so I had to change my name.
We get along very, very well, which is a blessing. We couldn't have done it as long as we have if we haven't gotten along well. We still have four of basically the original core members, and for a six-piece that's been around for 16 years, 17 years almost, that's pretty impressive, you know, to have four of the original guys. But, you know, we're in a van. You know, we're a small band. We don't make a lot of money. We lose money when we tour, hence why we can't do it a whole lot. We do it because we love it, but... we're in a van, and you know, we stay at people's houses or travel lodges every night, and we're on top of each other, man. I mean, we're sitting arm to arm, you know, so when somebody, you know, rips a fart, which happens a lot when you've been drinking all day and night and eating bad food, it can be pretty brutal, you know, and you can get on each other's nerves, but you've done it so long, you sort of learn how to just breathe easy. Well, not if somebody ripped the fart, but breathe easy in general, and you know, just kind of, you know, get through the little bump in the road. So we're lucky that way, but we have done bus tours over here, and those are awesome. There's a reason why people do those buses, because there's just space, there's room, you can walk around while you travel. Like if you wanted to walk up and down and you know, in between bunks, you can do that. If you wanted to lay out in a lounge and watch a movie, you can do that. And they're so expensive and it's so hard to travel on a bus, but it's a pretty cool experience, you know. I would like to be on a bus again someday in the future, but the only way that's happening is if we split it with somebody, you know. Probably pass out in a comfortable bed, because I've been on those goddamn Travel Lodge box springs beds all week. But probably take a hot shower with a lot of pressure, which is something that's hard to come by over here. Showers don't have a lot of pressure. I don't know why. But a hot shower with a lot of pressure, lay in a nice, super comfortable bed. You know, very excited to see my dogs, you know, it's always good to run around and play with them. And then food. Oh God. I mean, hey, let's be honest. I mean, like the food in America, there's a reason why we're big, fat, and lazy over there. You know, the food's awesome. So I'll probably get something really flavorful that I haven't been able to have, like Mexican food. We're from California, so the Mexican food is tremendous. So probably that'll be my plan. Heaping Mexican food, hot shower, see the dogs, pass out on a bed. That's the game plan, you know. Just always thanks for the support. We've been around for a long time, and we appreciate you still supporting us, caring enough to even ask us some questions. You can find us at Facebook, Army of Freshmen, Twitter, at Army of Freshmen, armyoffreshmen.com. Please hop on YouTube, check out the videos, follow us on those sites, say hi, say hello, support unsigned bands, and look out for Betting on Baker, our movie that should be coming out next year, Betting on Baker, and you can go on Facebook to find out more information about that.